Craig Cameron, Gloves Red, here with the British champion, Cash Fruit. Cash, how are you?
I'm good, Cameron. Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm good. So we're just over 2 weeks out to Dwayne Winters,
next
opponent, and your opportunity to retain the British Lonsdale belt.
Yeah, that's right.
How's preparations going?
Oh, it's been great. You know, I've been in camp since April, and I've not really took time off since my last fight. I went straight back into camp. I knew I would have been defending around this time, so I went right back into camp, and you know, I've just been training since. I mean, sparring-wise, everything, I've had great preparation for this, and I'm ready to go. You know, I'm only 2 weeks away. Well, 2 weeks tomorrow, and I'm ready to fight. You know.
Yeah, and Craig was mentioning that you're going to Hartlepool for some sparring in the morning. You've been down there before.
Yeah.
I noticed that you'd been sparring with Sonny Edwards. How was that experience?
No, it was brilliant. You know, Sonny is, you know, I mean, as you know, he's the top of his game at the moment, and he's on his way up, and that was a great experience for me. As much as it's good for experience for him and me, you know, I mean, but both, you know, up and coming, and you know, it's a really tactical spar, and it's brilliant. You know, yeah. I picked out a few tips, you know, definitely.
And was a wee bit of concern because your potential rival in the future, Lee McGregor,
no,
shares the same gym, or do you not look at it like
no,
that?
No, I don't look at it that way, you know, and see, and there's Sonny's a different style from Lee McGregor, and you know, it's different, two different styles, and you know, it wouldn't make up a difference, you know, in the night, to be honest. Yeah, whenever the fight does come off, you know, it doesn't make a big difference because Sonny's a back foot fighter, he's a counter puncher, and Lee McGregor's different. I mean, altogether, he's tall, rangy. Sonny's about my height.
Yeah, great. So, Cash, you were the first British Pakistani to win the title. What's it going to mean for you to retain that and be the first person ever to do that?
Oh, it's going to mean, you know, I mean, it's going to mean a lot to me, definitely. And you know, I started off my pro career. I didn't expect to win the Scottish title and just to win the British and even win it outright. So, I feel I've achieved a lot, you know, and I hope I can keep the success up and keep going. But it's obviously, I remember I'm working double as hard, you know, and I put a lot of work in the last 3 or 4 years, and you know, and hope you know, I mean, all the work's paying off, you know.
Yeah, I came in here a couple of hours, Cash. I've not seen you stop working since I came in, whereas some other people are taking breathers, now you drink a water, you know, you're
No, definitely. I've been here since 5:30, so that's me just done right now.
You?
So I always come 30-40 minutes before Craig does, so
yeah.
And I get warmed up, practice everything I need to do, and work on tactics, and just get fit as I can and work on the tactics for the fight night, you know.
And what's your typical day training like? Is it two sessions, three sessions, Cash, are you?
It just depends on the day, you know, and I think maybe 2-3 times a week I do three sessions sometime. Then most of the days is just twice a week, and take Saturdays off, and Sundays I start over again. So usually people start on Mondays, but I usually start on Sundays. We come in your Renfrewshire box and we do our morning session, and I go out run nighttime, and you know, it's just like that from Sunday to Friday every week.
Uh-huh. And I know you were in attendance, I was there as well, yeah, when Lee McGregor fought Scott Allen,
yeah,
a fighter that you know well.
Yeah.
How did you rate Lee's performance that night?
I thought it was a good performance, you know. I think Lee was out the ring for a while, so you know, it wasn't the best of performance, but I thought it was a good performance overall, you know, and he done what he had to do, he got the win and got Scott Allen out there, and but Scott Allen had a lot of success in the fight as well, and you know, but you know, overall it was a good performance.
Yeah, and it's probably a name you're sick of hearing, Lee McGregor.
Yeah,
but do you think the fans are asking, do you think it's a fight that we will see this year?
I think you will, definitely, because obviously, as you know, the British Board Control put it out. I think he's mandated to box the winner of this fight. So, but obviously, I'm focused on doing Winters, and you know, then hopefully we can just see where it goes next. I mean, after this fight, definitely.
Yeah, and what's your aspirations, would you say, for the remainder of this year? Would it be that, maybe that fight with McGregor, and then we'll see what 2020 brings?
For me, it's just fight at a time. Dwayne Winters is in front of me, that's my right now, my mindset. I want to win that fight first, and that's it. Then next step, if I've got the fight lined up, then that's the thing. But for me, it's always fight at a time, and that's it. I look who's in front of me, and that's it. I don't try looking, look at this guy, and I look 2 fights ahead, or I look at world stage. No, for me, I want to win this British shot, right? And Dwayne Winters is my way, and so I need to focus on him 100%.
That's brilliant. Cash, listen, I just want to thank you for taking the time to speak to us, and I want to wish you all the best on the 17th of August.
Thanks,
and we'll speak to you soon.
Thank you.
All right, cheers, Cash.